Border Gateway Protocol, BGP, is a standardized exterior gateway protocol designed to exchange routing and reachability information among autonomous systems on internet. Okay, that's what is written on Wikipedia and much more. But I would like to rephrase the way many people simply explain BGP. That BGP is like a postal service of internet which defines certain set of rules and agreements to be followed by post offices, governed by that postal service, in order to send the mails to their correct destinations in fast, cost-effective and reliable way. Post offices of BGP postal service are called autonomous systems or AS. Fair enough, that's one of the simplest way to get motivated to start reading RFC 1771 for BGP version 4. You can find the RFC link in the description. Hello, my name is Kamal Bhatt and I'm working as a software product manager at STORDIS. And today I'm going to speak about configuring BGP on Broadcom Enterprise SONiC switches. We will be using GNS3 virtual topology to configure BGP in this video. To know how to create topology with Broadcom Enterprise SONiC switches in GNS3, please watch the video with the link on the screen or in the description. Afterwards, we will have an in-depth look into BGP packets being transferred using Wireshark. Internet is a network of hundreds of thousands of smaller networks, or autonomous systems, or ACs in short, which we just called to be post offices in above said example of postal services. And each AS, which is a smaller network, may have several devices, including application servers, storage servers, packet brokers, switches, routers, PCs, and many more. But who is running those ACs? It's ISPs, or internet service providers. Also, can be government organizations, technical giants to small businesses, educational institutions, etc. Those business bodies are often competitors to each other. This is where BGP is different from regular postal service, because in postal services, we know people running local post offices are not competitors of each other. They simply follow the rules of governing postal service. So, whenever a user makes a request on internet, it's BGP, which not only decides the best route to your request, also takes business decisions into account. For example, one ISP may not want to route the incoming request to a university AS. Such decisions can be implemented in BGP. After that, many factors and ACs in between, it's no surprise noticing that your request and responses may follow different paths. Out of curiosity, if you wish to see the AC's route of your request from your laptop itself over the internet in real time, there is a simple tool called TraceRoute available on Windows, Mac, and Linux platforms. Further, if you wish to see the details of a specific autonomous system your request traveled through, there is another tool called WhoIs. Here you can see the AS number along with several other details of that AS or autonomous system. Now, let's proceed with configuring BGP on Broadcom Enterprise SONiC devices created in GNS3. If you want to know more on how to create a GNS3 topology with Broadcom Enterprise SONiC devices, please see the video with the link on the screen or in the description. On GNS3, you can see command in the text boxes for configuring BGP next to respective spine and leaf nodes. Those configurations are available in GitHub repository as well. Link is in the description. You can simply copy and paste commands on the consoles of respective switches. On the spine switch, we have configured loopback with the management address of the switch, and then its switching port Ethernet 0 and Ethernet 1 with any IP. Those switching ports you can consider behaving like border or edge routers or external BGP peers, as they will exchange BGP information with external autonomous systems. And this whole spine switch can be considered as a whole autonomous system with ASID 65000 assigned using command router BGP 65000. I plan those edge routers or switching ports Ethernet 0 and Ethernet 1 to connect to external ACs configured on leaf switches as BGP neighbors with ASIDs 65101 and 65102 with their IPs. Configuration of next AS or switch leaf 1 is also like spine switch, except both the leaf switches have single neighbor, which is spine. And of course, different IPs of the edge and ASIDs as shown in the commands on the screen. After finishing configuration, please save it with the command sudo config save-y. Otherwise, the configuration will not persist after the next cold boot or power cycle. Also, you can verify the BGP configuration and BGP message exchanged by BGP neighbors with the command given at the bottom of the collection. Now, let's have a look into BGP messages exchanged between two BGP peers. BGP RFC 1771 defines four types of messages. Number one, open message. This is the first message sent by each side after the transport layer connection is established. Open message mainly contains BGP attributes. Number two, update message. Transfers routing information between BGP peers, which is used to construct a graph describing the relationship of various autonomous systems. Number three, keep alive message, used to determine reachability status with peers. And number four, notification message, is sent when an error condition is detected. To view messages exchanged in real time in GNS3, just right click on an interface and click Start Capture. This should automatically launch a Wireshark window. And yes, you must have Wireshark already installed on your machine to make it happen. Just type BGP in the filter box in Wireshark. This way, only BGP messages will appear. To view the sequence of BGP messages exchanged from beginning, let's re-establish the BGP connection. This can simply be done by disabling and enabling an edge router, or to be specific, the Ethernet port 0 of the leaf switch. Now we can see all BGP messages exchanged to establish the path from beginning in Wireshark, starting from very first open message. Let's have a deeper look into BGP messages exchanged. BGP summary command on this leaf node shows its one neighbor and the prefixes sent and received by its neighbor with IP 1.1.1.1. Please note, prefix sent field tells about prefixes sent by the mentioned neighbor, but not this router, To inspect only prefixes sent by neighbor in Wireshark, let's enhance our filter with the IP source to be the neighbor, which is 1.1.1.1. IP prefixes are sent in BGP update messages, encoded as a two-tuple form, length of prefix and IP prefix itself. BGP is a path vector protocol, which means BGP carries the path information along. A prefix announced by an AS to its neighbors consists of IPv4 or IPv6 address block and a path made up of AS numbers, indicating which ACs the traffic must pass through to reach the announced address block. As you can clearly see in BGP update messages in network layer reachability information, or NLRI, the IP prefix and AS path in path attributes. The count of prefixes sent by this neighbor to this router is 6. And to inspect prefixes received by the neighbor 1.1.1.1, just change the filter in Wireshark from IP source to IP destination. As we are monitoring the single link on Wireshark, there is no need to provide additional filter with IP of peer in Wireshark. On CLI, in the output of BGP summary command, messages received and message sent field shows the total number of all types of BGP sent and received messages by this neighbor. For further analysis of BGP packets, I have placed the packet capture file in GitHub along with the BGP configuration used in this topology in GNS3. Feel free to browse through. Link is in the description. Hope you find the video informative. Please share your valuable feedback in comments. For more information on open networking products like Broadcom Enterprise SONiC, please write to us at support@stordis.com.